Hello viewers, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this tutorial demonstration, we will see the analysis of heat transfer in an annulus between two concentric rotating cylinders. There are two concentric cylinders, which are rotating in opposite directions at the same magnitude of 20 radians per second. The inner cylinder is at 305 Kelvin, whereas the outer cylinder is R295 Kelvin. The space between these two cylinders is filled with glycerin. Find out the velocity variations along the radial direction. Draw a radial velocity variation in a chart and export the velocity variations as Excel data. From this demonstration, you would be able to know how to create a 2D geometry in ANSYS Design Modeler, how to mesh the geometry using all quadrilateral cells in ANSYS meshing, how to check skewness, orthogonal quality, the aspect ratio of the mesh, how to set up a moving wall boundary condition in ANSYS Fluent, how to change the number of arrows in the velocity vector. We would create the 2D geometry in ANSYS geometry creation tool, that is ANSYS Design Modeler. We'll mesh the geometry using ANSYS meshing. Then after the generation of mesh, we will set up the ANSYS Fluent solver, and finally, after the calculations, we will check the results in ANSYS CFD Postprocessing. All these tools can be found under a single workbench, that is ANSYS Fluid Flow, Fluent. So let's open this workbench first. Select the ANSYS Fluid Flow from the toolbox, double-click on it, alternatively drag it into the project schematic window. Click on the geometry, now you would be able to see a properties table in the right side of the window. Scroll down in it to the advanced properties, in this choose the analysis type to 2D, as we are going to do a 2D analysis. Now, right-click on geometry. Select the second option, that is ANSYS Design Modeler, to create the geometry. Change the default units to millimeter. Select the XY plane, click on the Z to make the sketch normal to the screen. Switch to Sketching tab and select Circle from the Draw Tools. Draw two circles with center at the origin. Provide dimensions to these circles. Now, in the Sketch Details table, select the dimension and put the diameter of the inner circle as 140 mm and outer cylinder as 240 mm. The sketch is complete. Now convert this sketch to a 2D geometry using the Surface from Sketch option. Click on anywhere on the sketch and press Apply. Then click on Generate to create the 2D geometry. Creation of the geometry is now complete. Close the Design Modeler and proceed for meshing. Open the meshing. The 2D geometry created will now be opened in the meshing. In our previous tutorial, I had shown how to mesh using the default mesh setting. In this video, I will show you how you could do the custom mesh sizing. Insert the sizing option. Select the edge selection option and select the edges of the geometry. Then click on Apply. Now select the sizing type as number of divisions, enter the number of divisions as 300, the mesh will divide each edge into 300 divisions. Change the mesh behavior to hard, so the mesh will only follow the number of divisions to mesh. Right-click on mesh and select Generate Mesh. It will now mesh the geometry as per the current sizing input. Right-click on mesh, then insert method. Select the entire geometry by face selection and press Apply. Select the method as quadrilateral dominant and mesh type as all quad. It will convert any triangular cells and will result in all quadrilateral cells in the mesh. Some of the triangular cells are still present in the mesh. Now click on mesh, then insert, then select face meshing, then generate the mesh. It will distribute the meshed cells uniformly. All quadrilateral cells are distributed uniformly over the mesh. Click on statistics to check the number of elements and nodes generated. To check the quality of the mesh, select the quality, then select the mesh metrics. Here select the orthogonal quality. A mesh metrics chart will be displayed. Click on the chart to see the meshed cells having the same orthogonal quality. Similarly, check the skewness and aspect ratio of the meshed cells. To name the boundary surfaces, choose the Edge Selection tool and select the edges. Then right-click and select Create Name Selection option. Now provide a name to the boundary surface. Similarly, name the outer boundary surface. Though it's not necessary to name the fluid domain in this case, as here there is only one domain. But, in case of multiple domains, it's recommended to provide name selection to all the domains. It will help the user to distinguish between cells' zones. Right-click and update the mesh. It will link the meshed cells with the CFD solver. At the same time, you will receive a message regarding successful mesh transition to Fluent. Close the meshing and proceed for the solver setup. Double-click on Setup to open the solver setup. For the current simulation, select the double precision model and press OK. Click on the models. Select the viscous model as laminar. Also, turn on the energy model, as there is heat interaction between the cylinders to be calculated. Click on the materials. Add the material properties of glycerin from the Fluent database. Now, assign the material in the cell zone. Now to put the boundary conditions. Select the inner cylinder wall. Choose Moving Wall option in Momentum tab. Select the rotation motion. As we had created the geometry at the origin, so keep the rotational axis at the origin. Put the angular velocity value. Positive velocity value denotes anti-clockwise rotation. And negative velocity value denotes clockwise rotation. Switch to a thermal tab and enter the cylinder wall temperature and wall thickness. Select the outer cylinder wall and put the boundary conditions. Select the moving wall option and put the rotational velocity. The negative rotational velocity will result in a clockwise rotation. Switch to the thermal tab and put the outer cylinder temperature and wall thickness. In solution method, select the coupled scheme, pressure-velocity coupling. Go to monitors, select residuals. Decrease the residuals up to 10 to the power minus 6. It will increase the solution accuracy. Do the hybrid initialization. It will complete the solver setup process. Put the number of iterations and start the calculation. The calculation gets completed. As all the governing equations attain the set residual value, so the solution gets converged. Click on the results, select the vector to plot the velocity vector. In the vector display window, select the numbers of vectors to skip to observe the velocity vectors properly. As you can see, near the inner cylinder wall, the velocity vectors are moving along anti-clockwise rotation. And the velocity is changing its direction gradually, as it moves away from the origin, along the radial direction. Save the project and proceed for CFD post-processing. Double-click on results to open the CFD post-processing. Click on the velocity vector option. Select the location. Then click on apply. It will display the vector as per the default settings. Increase the factor so that it will skip some of the vectors, so that you can observe the velocity variations properly. Switch to Symbols tab to change the symbol and its size. To save the image, click on the camera icon. Choose the location where you want to save the file. Change the default image size and background. Insert the contour to see the variations in the fluid domain. Select the location and the variable. Then click on Apply. To change the color map, select the default legend view from the tree outline. Select the precision and click on Apply. Save the contour image for any future use. Similarly, check the temperature contour. This is the pressure contour. Make the contour display off. Select the insert option to insert a line. Put the coordinates of the line. Put the number of sample points on the line. Click on Apply. We will observe the velocity variations at each sample points using a chart. Go to Insert menu and insert a chart. Switch to Data Series tab and select the line in the location box. Choose the radial length variable in the x-axis and velocity in the y-axis. This is the velocity variation plot along the radial direction. To save the velocity value at each sample point, click on Export, then select the location on the computer and Save. It will save the file as .csv file format. You can use any of the Excel programs to open this file. To observe the temperature variations, go to Insert tab, then insert a new chart. Select the radial length in x-axis and temperature in the y-axis. This is the temperature variations plot along radial direction. With this, let's conclude this demonstration. In our upcoming videos, we will show more basic tutorial demonstrations, which would be very helpful for you. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications of our new uploads. If you like this video, then please press the like button below. If you have any query or suggestions, then please comment. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.